Sparks, it's great to see you. I hope you've had a really good week. Still very strange, isn't it? But we'll get through this. I hope you and your families are really well. We're going to be learning today about Lot and Abram. Now, I've got a compass here to show you, and we're going to be thinking about going in different directions. I'm going to play a game, okay? There are 4 points on a compass. North, south, east, and west. I want you, in the room that you're in, to mark out where you think north should be, where south should be, where east should be, and west should be. Okay, so just do that in your head. North, south, east, and west. Okay? Now, in the room that you're in, I want you to face north. Okay? Now, I want you to take 3 paces north. Okay? Don't take too big a strides because I don't know how big your room is. Okay? Now, I want you to turn around and face south. And take 5 steps south. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I want you to turn to the west and take 2 steps. 1, 2. Now I want you to turn to the north and take 2 steps. 1, 2. Now, turn to the east and take 6 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now turn around and take 3 steps to the west. 1, 2, 3. Now, if my calculations are right, you should be back where you started. Did that work? Hope so. Okay. In last week's session with Chris, we learned that Abram was in Canaan, but there was a famine there. That means that there wasn't enough food for the people to eat. So Abram and all the things that he owned moved south to Egypt, and they stayed there. Sometime later, they moved north from Egypt back to Canaan. Now Abram was with Sarai, his wife, and Lot, his nephew. That means his brother's son. And between them, they had lots of animals and lots of things. Abram left there, and they kept moving from place to place. And then they stopped near a place called Bethel. Abram was very rich. He had loads of sheep and goats and cattle and silver and gold. And Lot also had lots of those things. And he also had his own family too. Now, because of all the animals that these guys owned, there wasn't enough land for them. Because all their sheep and camels and goats and cattle had eaten all the grass. They had too many animals between them. And the men who were looking after all these animals started to argue between them about who could be where and who couldn't be where. So, Abram told Lot to choose where he wanted to go. He said if Lot went one way, then Abram would go the other way. But if Lot wanted to go that way, then Abram would go in the opposite way. So Abram gave Lot the choice. Lot looked east and moved to the Jordan Valley. Abram stayed in Canaan. So Lot to the east and Abram to the west. When Lot left, God spoke to Abram this is what he said. It's in the Old Testament part of the Bible, right in the first book of the Bible, in Genesis chapter 13, verses 14 to 16. It says, "After Lot left, the Lord said to Abram, 'Look around you, look north and south and east and west. All this land I give to you. All this land you see, I will give to you and your descendants forever. I will make your descendants as many as the dust of the earth. If anyone can count the dust on the earth, he could count your people.'" Now, that's an amazing promise of God, isn't it, to Abram? That he would have as many descendants as there is specks of dust on the earth. Can you remember what a descendant is? A descendant is children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren and great-great-great-grandchildren. And it goes on and on and on. And the family gets bigger and bigger and bigger. But there was a big problem at the moment. Abram and Sarai didn't have any children. So how was that going to happen? Well, we know that we have a loving and a caring God who always keeps his promises. God's promises to Abram are getting bigger. He didn't just promise a few descendants. He promised lots and lots of descendants, too many to count. And he also promised land. Land in every direction, north, south, east and west, as far as Abram could see. And Jesus told us that nothing is impossible for God. That's in Mark chapter 10, verse 27. Everything is possible with God. That means that God can do anything. Human beings can't do anything, but God can. Nothing is too difficult for him. And we need to remember that. So now we're going to pray. Remember our prayer drill? 1, 2, 3. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the good things you give us. Thank you for the promises that God made to Abram and that we know have come true. We know that you have many, many descendants, and that we pray that you will help us to believe and know that nothing is impossible for you. And pray for us this week as we have a new week of homeschooling and being at home with our families. Help us to be kind and loving and thoughtful to one another and to do as we're told. Amen. Okay, now the craft this week is quite simple. I've got two pictures for you to draw. Now on the screen I have put up some instructions on where you can find these pages, because I didn't think they were very easy to find. So the instructions can be found at holytrinity.org, no, wrong, holytrinityspittle.org. Next week, and there's a little button down at the bottom underneath the video where you can download these pictures. So on the first one, I would like you to draw a picture of a very pretty land with lots of green grass and mountains and sun and trees, and very, very pretty. Okay, so that's on that one. And on this one, I'd like you to draw as many descendants as you can. Remember, it started with Abram, so he must have had some children, and then some more children and grandchildren and grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren and great-great-great-great-grandchildren. So I want you to see if you can draw a picture of Abram and Sarah and their descendants. Okay, now what we'd like also is for you to send your pictures so they can go on our photo wall. Again, I'm going to put the instructions up so your mums or dads can send your pictures. Afraid kids can't have the pictures of you, just your artwork. OK? okay? So you can send that, and then maybe next week you can see if your picture's on the art wall, okay? So I hope you have a really good week, and remember the promises that we've been making. Well, God's been making some very, very big promises, hasn't he? So I wonder if we can promise to love our families more and more each day, and to do what we're asked to do. Try and think what would make somebody in your house happy, and do it before they ask you to do it. That would be really great. Okay, I hope we'll see you next time. Take care. Lots of love. Bye bye.